Julie Malloy is like most young mothers. She washes dishes, makes sandwiches, changes diapers, and loves little Landon more than life.
He's my world.
She walks like we do, works like we do, even fumbles with car seats like we do. But Julie has a secret.
Just by looking at me, you would never know.
It started when Julie was 2. She burned the skin off the palms of her hands on a hot stove, but never cried a single tear. Her alarmed parents rushed her to the hospital, where she would spend day after day, enduring dozens of surgeries, living years with braces on her legs. Photos show the bandages, but these snapshots hide her pain.
I always thought, why did it happen to me?
There was a 1 in 99 million chance that Julie's parents both carried the same gene, which they did.
I watch every step that I take.
It's called hereditary sensory neuropathy type 2. Julie feels nothing from her shoulders down to her toes. Not this soft grass or this cool water or the warmth of her son in her arms.
If I'm buying something at the store, they don't give my change back to me because they don't want to touch my hands.
For years, she's endured the stares and the infections and the injuries, and she has had each finger amputated at least 4 times because her wounds just don't heal.
A paper cut could have turned into that.
Julie gets by with special scissors and a tool to manage buttons. Slip-on shoes cover her battered, bloodied feet. Her makeup is tattooed on, and everything she does by sight.
And if I close my eyes, I have no idea.
You're listening now, huh?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
But I used all my ears. I can't tell you how I gripped it.
When you look down and you look at your hands, what do you see?
Nubs.
Does it bother you?
Yes.
At 29, Julie Malloy is all alone.
The blind people have the blind center, the deaf people have the deaf community. I said, but what support system is there for a disorder that there's only 50 people that they know of in the whole world to have this?
Enter Alisa Joseph, Julie's angel. When Alisa learned of Julie's disorder,
she's alone. She's alone with this.
She created the Hearts to Hands Foundation and started fundraising. Nut sales and teas, raffles and car washes, all to buy Julie the greatest gift, hands. Sarah Wooden at Ability Prosthetics and Orthotics took the molds and matched Julie's skin color. Artists recreated the wrinkling and the redness around her knuckles, and the shape of each fingernail comes from Julie's father. Today, for the first time, Julie gets to see what her new hands will look like.
That's the first in my life that I will ever have fingernails. First in my life.
A $30,000 wish granted by one woman on one mission.
I want some emotional healing for her as well as these fingers.
To grant this single mother with one singular burden, the greatest gift of all, normalcy.
I don't dream about much in life. This is a dream come true.